Hi, everybody. Welcome to another week of the Successful Woman's Mindset Book Launch Summit. My name is Galit Ventura Rosen. I'm a business performance expert, and now I can even say I'm an author, which is fun. And I'm excited because all of this, every Monday, we're going to be interviewing different female entrepreneurs that, to me, embody the successful woman's mindset. So today, I'm excited to have Amber Griffiths with me.
Hello there, Galit. How are you?
Welcome. So tell, remind me where you live, Amber.
I'm in Utah. I'm in Salt Lake City.
That's right. Now I remember. Yeah, it's not too far. It's a jump and a skip from Las Vegas.
Exactly. An hour trip.
It's a beautiful, beautiful city. I've been there many times. I'm excited to have you, and I would love to get started with, what does the successful woman's mindset mean to you?
I think with the most successful mindset, it's this belief that you get to have more, that you are enough, that you are more than enough, and whatever you have in your heart of hearts, that's perfect. This mindset is like, for me, it's this true rock star. There's no apologies, no caveats, no disclaimers. No, I'm going to play small so that other people aren't intimidated. It's watch out, world. This is me. I am everything. It's 100% who you really are inside and sharing that with the world. So it's not playing small because it's scary or whatever. It's just that mindset of everything I have is perfect and everything I am is enough. And I have every right, in fact, a responsibility to share that with the world.
So. Oh, I love that. I love that. I always talk so much about this pay it forward. I use the word duty a lot, which maybe is not the best word, but for me, I almost feel like it's a duty that we should, as women, especially a lot of us women that have learned about each other and gotten to know each other. And I always share, so many of us have never met in person. Yeah. We've only met through video and or through social media, but there's this connection of support. And I just want to make that very clear. One of the things I really talk about in my book is, if you don't have that circle around you, find them because they exist.
Yep.
If you don't have that person in your corner that you share every crazy idea with that says to you, you go, girl, find them. I found this world, and I know you have too, Amber. That's how we met. This world of women out there in the entrepreneur social media, which means we do a lot on social media. We share, we want to do better, that are there and want to uplift and support. Haven't you found the same?
Oh, absolutely. It was one of those things when I first started my business, I thought I really wanted to focus on men because women kind of were scary and intimidating. And the more I get out there, you realize that honest and truly, especially when you find the ones that do have that successful mindset, that are being playing full out, they are not, I get to play big, so you have to be small. They're like, come on up. Everybody's partying up here. We're all playing huge up here. It's a huge tribe of supportive people. And you're absolutely right. If you look around and your top 10 people aren't those people, find a new community, find a new tribe. They are out there waiting for you. They've got a seat pulled out for you, all warmed up. Just find them.
And they don't have to be in your city.
No.
It's okay if they're in your city, but some people don't have that opportunity. They live in small towns, don't have as many organizations, whatever. They are there. And the way to find them really is to just kind of look around. And today it's so easy with social media, LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram. And there's so many groups out there that share with you. I have a group called Galit's Women Empowering Women on Facebook. So there's a group just like what you're talking about, where people go in and they just support and share. I have a day where you just share your successes,
which is awesome. You should be able to celebrate those
and not feel like you're bragging, feel like you're proud of yourself, feel like the people that love you or know you are proud of you.
Yeah.
Haven't you found that, Amber, where you share something amazing with someone and they're just so dang excited for you?
Oh. It's a little crazy. In fact, I shared something last week. I won an award and there was part of me going, oh, I don't want to say.
What did you win?
It's a Best of the West award. It was
Yeah. Congratulations. was that for your business, for branding?
Yeah, it was for branding business. But what was amazing is out of all these tips that I think are so helpful that I share about branding, I got more interaction and congratulations on that little post. I felt so loved.
Isn't that beautiful?
I mean, it was incredible. It was incredibly
humbling. But it wasn't even in your little circle. It was this huge array. All right. So I got sidetracked because I didn't want to talk to Amber. No, it was me. I haven't even told everybody how awesome you are yet. So let me do that. Amber is a branding rock star and speaker driven by the belief that every entrepreneur has a unique story that only they can share. She has spent more than 2 decades working with hundreds of business owners, creating brands worth hundreds of thousands of dollars. Amber is currently a member of multiple women's organizations, such as eWomen Network, Women's Coaching Association, and the Public Speakers Association, which is how we met. She is dedicated to helping create your rock star brand that is clear, cohesive, and converts. And I got so excited to ask you what it meant. I totally forgot to introduce myself. But this is how we roll.
Yes, yes, it's all good.
Flow. Amber and I get in on an interview and we just go.
It's perfect. It's exactly how it should be.
Perfectly crazy, just like we are. So please share with us how you feel you embody the successful woman's mindset and how you help your clients embody it as well.
Oh, absolutely. I think the biggest part of that is really the rock star portion of that, which is the no apologies, no caveats. I completely, unapologetically, unabashedly go after my vision. This is what the difference I want to make in the world. This is what I want my lifestyle to be. And I help my clients create that exact same thing. We dive deep into what are your core values? What's important to you? What did you say you wanted? And it's not because, because sometimes that shifts or sometimes you get influenced by other people. So we really dive into what is important to you. What is that 100% that you feel a little scared or feel maybe confused as to how to share that with the world? So once we tap into that and we create a brand specifically around that, the sky's the limit. You get to make more money. You get to work with clients that excite you and you get to be paid to do what you love to do. So it's just this whole pile of success and awesome and fun. And the people around you are exactly the same way.
So do you feel like you embody the successful woman's mindset because you are so in tune with, I want you to shine. I want people to get you. And the only way they're really going to get you is if I get you, so I can make sure that you're seen in the light that you want to.
Absolutely. I think part of what happens is, especially as a female entrepreneur, it's not necessarily like you don't want to be 100%. You're not quite sure how, or you're a little frightened of how to do it. Or someone has shoved you down into this box that said, this is what this looks like. And I think that's nonsense. I think that people lose out, not only you, but the people you're meant to serve. If they don't get to see you at 100%, they miss out. So really, you've got to be super clear about what that is and make sure that shines. And to heck with the box, you get to just live large and be you.
It's funny, right before Amber and I went live, I shared a story with her, how when I got started, I spoke to multiple branding experts. I hadn't known Amber yet. And one of them immediately within the first 5 minutes said, well, what are your colors that you would like for your branding? And I said, blue and yellow. And if anybody knows me, it's the blue that Amber's wearing and I'm yellow. And she immediately said to me, well, those are not the most typical colors to use to be most successful in your website. I suggest this color and this color. And within 5 minutes, I said, oh, heck no. I am not 8 years old or 12 or 15. I don't need somebody putting me in a box anymore. I want people to see who I am. I don't need to have some generic colors that are successful in the world of websites, because if that's who I'm going to attract, I'm not interested.
Right.
So Amber really works with you to get down and deep into who you are, what you love. Because if you don't love your branding, people aren't going to love your branding either, because they're going to know it's not authentic.
Right? Yeah, absolutely. They can sniff that out from a mile away. You really have to embody it. And that doesn't mean you have to wear it all the time or have every single thing you need to have your logo on it, although I suggest that. If you embody that, that's your values, that's your belief, it's your story. And if you can't own 100% of that, then we need to have a conversation.
Yeah, and it's a way, there's a process, as you know, to get you to feeling comfortable with who you are. One of the chapters in my book is called She is Visible. in the Successful Woman's Mindset. And for me, you embody that chapter, because if you're not visible, if they don't see who you are, if they don't see you, you cannot live your purpose. You cannot work with others in your purpose. And it could be a product that you believe in. It could be a service. It could be anything that you do. But I want you to really think about that. And Amber embodies that in her work, where she goes, look, how is somebody going to find you? How is somebody going to know who you are if we don't make sure we make the best and also the quickest impression? Because today, I was talking to Amber about this earlier, we're making these interviews 15 minutes because a lot of people are busy. They don't have time. So you want them to see who you are, know that they want to get to know you better in the shortest amount of time. And when you have a branding expert, and I love Amber's branding, because she talks about the rock star branding a lot. And I love the word rock star, because you know me, rock star.
Love music.
fun.
Absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely.
So please tell everybody what you're offering today as a free gift to them.
Okay, absolutely. I would love to have a conversation with you. So what I'm offering is a half an hour of a branding consultation, completely complimentary. Let's dive into your brand. Let's see what's amazing. Let's see what needs a little bit of tweaking and create a path to create your rockstar brand. You can find that and claim that by going to yourbrandbydesign.com/duet, D-U-E-T. That means one-on-one, just me and you talking about your brand.
And we'll make sure we put the link in underneath the Facebook Live, yeah, as well as in all of the emails that are going to go out, because a lot of people will be watching this in replay. And how can they get a hold of you, Amber, aside from the free gift?
Aside from that, you can always find me on social media. You can find me on Facebook. It's Branding Rockstar. You can find me at yourbrandbydesign.com. And there's my phone number. You can get a hold of me any other way there. Yep.
Yes,
I'm all over.
I know, right? It's so much fun. And of course, she's got all of her branding done, and she is visible, because that's part of the Successful Woman's Mindset. And I'm going to also share with you, if you're interested in purchasing my book and learning more about my programs, visit thesuccessfulwomansmindset.com. I'm very excited to be sharing the book with the world. And I'm excited that Amber shared her knowledge today about branding. Make sure to reach out to her. Thank you. Thank you, Amber, for being a part of this summit.
Thank you so much. It's an absolute pleasure. I'm excited to see how the book turns out. I'm excited to be affected like that.
I'm ready for everyone to read it. I think it'll be an amazing tool to use always, because the Successful Woman's Mindset should be a part of every woman's day. Business, lifestyle, doesn't matter what it is. But thank you so much for watching another interview. And my name is Galit Ventura-Rosen, and I will see you next time.